Hello kids, today we have money chapter. Money need no introduction. You all know the importance of money in our daily life. Aslam saved rupees 3,150 previous year and rupees 2,260 this year. How much money did he save? So you all know that we have to add this. Very important part is always put symbol of rupees. This is must to put in front of amount. So we will add this and find out the amount. But today we are going to learn the unitary method. What is unitary method? Finding the price of one item of a kind is called finding the unit price. First we have to take out the unit price of that kind. This method is called unitary method. Means now Saurabh bought a 4 lollipop for rupees 36. 4 lollipops for rupees 36. Now unitary method means we have to find out the price of 11 lollipop. So first of all we have to take out the price of 1 lollipop, that is called unit price. First we take out the unit price, this method is called unitary method. Then we take out the amount which our question is demanding. Here we have sum of unitary method. John can earn rupees 450 in 15 days. How much money he will earn in 30 days? Now what we have to do? First, we according to unitary method, we will take out income of one day. Money John earned in 15 days, that is rupees 450. Money John earned in one day. So whenever we are doing one day, we have to divide it. So 30 rupees. 30 rupees, 30 John earned in one day. One day amount John earn in one day. So now it is clear that we have amount rupees 30. So what we have to do? Amount John earn in 30 days, simple. That is amount John earn in 30 days. So what we have to do? We have to do 30 multiply by 30. Rupees 30 multiply by 30. So what this is coming? 9. Amount John earn in 30 days, that is sum of unitary method is a worker is paid rupees 750 for 6 days of work. If he works for 23 days, how much money will he get? Now here we have 6 days. Amount 6 days we have, that is 750. First we have to take out unit, means one day amount. So amount worker is paid for 6 days, that is 750. So amount he is paid for one day, we have to divide this. So answer is 125. You all know how to do division. So divide 750 by 6 and the answer is 125. Now it is clear that is unit. Unit means one day. Amount he paid for one day, that is 125. Now we know the amount for one day. We have to take out the amount of 23 days. So what to do? We have to multiply the sum. Amount he paid for one day, that is 125. Amount he paid for 23 days, we will multiply it and we will get the answer. So we know the amount worker paid for 23 days, we have to take out. So amount worker is paid for one day, that is rupees 125. So we will take out this. For that, remove the sign of rupees and multiply 125 into 23. So first we take the table of 3, 3, 5 is 15, carry 1, 6 and 1, 7, 3. Now here we have 2, 5 is 10, 4, 5 and then we have 2. So the answer is 2875. So this is the answer. Amount worker is paid for 23 days, that is rupees. Now you put the sign. For answer, you put the sign rupees 2875. Worker is paid for 23 days. So unitary method means whatever is given and whatever is demanding the sum, first you take out one unitary unit, kind of unit, then you multiply it, the amount, that is sum is demanding. Now another method I am going to show you for unitary method. A car travel 228 km in 3 hours. How long will it take to travel 912 km? For that, this is another method that we do it joint. How to do this? 228 km a car travel in 3 hours. So 1 km you all know we have to put divide. But don't do division here. Then 912 km a car traveler. So whatever it is here, we will multiply by 912. Now this is short method. Now look at here that how to simplify this. Now you all know that this is even number, even number. So we will cut it by 2. 2 ones are 2, 2 ones are 2, 2 fours are 8. Here we have 2, 2 fours are 8. 2 5s are 10, 2 6s are 12. Now here we have, what we have? 5, 7. Here we have 2, 2, 8. Now 57, direct go with 4. You do it 57, multiply by 4. That is 2, 2, 8. It means this is divide by 4. So 4, 3s are 12 hours. So this is the way, another way to take out unitary method answer. Once again I repeat that 228 km a car travel in 3 hours. So 1 km for that we have to divide it. But don't do divide here. Just take this amount directly here. Now here we have 912 km a car travel. 3 upon 228 multiplied by 912. So you have to make it like smallest form. For that you see, if the number is even number, means the smallest prime number is 2. So we have to divide both the numbers by 2. So this is 114, 456. Then again both are even number. So again divide it, the smallest prime number, that is 2. So 57 here, 228 here. So then you take it, find it out by your own. So you come to know that 57 four times. Otherwise, another method is that you do multiplication, 228 multiplied by 3, then divide it by 57. But this is a long method. For short, first you have to see that if these two numbers are divisible by each other, then you do it in the smallest form. Make them in the smallest form, then you multiply it. So this is the way how we do it. 57 here, 228 here. So just count down. Take help of multiplication. If that is divisible by 57, then do it like that. So here now it is easy for you. 4 answer is here. 4